Alright, we're back with more Madden. Franchise. Okay, there we go. So let's do our good basic stuff. Let's just kill everyone. Let's just see what's in this draft, Karen. Oh. Oh my, A-minus, guys. And I need the right guard. Oh, we are so... Screw that, this guy's... Oh my, that's a very good one. Holy. I don't see A-minus on everything, except on quarterback, actually. Hopefully we can keep this first seeding. For the bye week. What about tackle? What about right tackle? Ooh, you're really far down. The farther down, the better, because it's probably gonna get picked up. Okay. Hunter. Nice. It's been a minute since I played. Skip. Playful. Right. Is Dalvin Cook really the highest overall player on our team? Yeah, what is it actually? Boost when outside runs. Okay. Alright, Cook, you're 4 yards away from getting 1,000 yards. Kendricks. Dang, Justin. Thielen. Poor Rudolph, he doesn't use much. I'm about to say, where's the announcers? Oh my, oh. He nearly broke. That would have been so bad. Oh yeah. They got a rookie quarterback, right? Lance? Yikes.
Number 30 numbers on the ground for Montgomery in last week's affair. 14 carries, 51 yards.
I'm so glad you asked for a couple of offensive linemen to talk to before the game, because they told us that in last week's contest, everything was clicking. Didn't matter whether they're doing gap scheme, zone scheme, power.
I went the wrong way.
It was working, and they expect more of the same in this game, although they're prepared for some adjustments by the defense they expect to see.
16 yards, a first down. 44 yard line. They're gonna look to throw.
Okay. Nice.
This one is down he goes. And the sack parade continues. Remember last week they had an astounding 8 sacks, another one there on the opening drive.
And they have the mentality of just attacking the quarterback in the pocket.
Nice team.
One of those teams that says,
3rd and 12, we're looking good. Who is that? Hughes?
So here come the Vikings as they get set for their first drive. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6-3 quarterback.
Okay, just to make sure I'm clear, you have not voted for NFL MVP yet, correct?
I always wait till the end.
I do the exact same thing, but let's just be honest here. Does he still have a shot? Here we are, week 16. Yeah. He's in the race, but is he really there?
Yeah, I think he needs a little help. It's French, don't you agree?
I agree. I think he needs a lot of help. People have to play poorly down the stretch around him in terms of the other people who are the candidates, and he needs to be absolutely spectacular. I think it's going to be really, really tough. But you know something? Being his team MVP, that's not such a bad thing, is it?
No, and he has been great for this team, no doubt about it. Eight quarters to prove himself.
Oh, that's wrong side of the... Oh, the juke was not good there.
The catch and run pays off for 29 yards.
That was a bad juke, man. I could have done better, I feel like.
At the 43. They'll look to throw here. Solid catch there for a man who's been so brilliant this year. Worth pointing out, as we were talking about earlier, there has never in the 60-year history of the award been a pass catcher, tight end, or wide receiver that has taken home the MVP trophy.
And the best receivers I've talked with, they know that stat, and it drives them crazy because they understand that without a quarterback, they don't make the plays that they make. They also don't feel like they...
Oh, Rudolph, you were so close.
The quarterback's made.
Absolutely, takes two to tango. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last two plays. Now about to start throwing the football. 4 for 4 on this opening drive.
Oh, he's slinging it. And oftentimes when you talk about slinging it, you're thinking about a guy throwing it all over the yard, not necessarily accurately. In this case, though, he's honing in on his...
And he'll get...
Nice.
...end zone touchdown, Minnesota. Dalvin Cook, his 26th touchdown, drawing even with Marshall Faulk for the fourth most in a single season. And the Vikings have taken a first quarter lead.
Nice.
Winning streak has been scoring first, an ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Nice. This time he doesn't get past the 30. Oh, Jacksonville and 49ers to 10-4-2. Did we lose to the 49ers? I can't remember. Probably. Oh, yeah, that was like the first loss of the season, I think.
They haven't had the season that they had hoped, so let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, think hard about them drafting multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stouter up front. And as a GM always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
36-yard line. First down, here's the run with Montgomery. And unable to get down.
Nice.
He'll take this up to about the 37.
Yeah, John Lynch, she's taking over for Michael Pierce. And didn't even draft him, I think. It was an Auburn draft, to be honest. I could have had that sack. It was late on my part. That should have been 2 sacks in a row.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first 2 drives. It looks like they're going to get the football again.
Dang it.
A punt of 46, a return of 5. And the Vikings will take over here, 1st and 10. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They have to be thrilled with that first drive.
Yeah, 4.
Now they'll be looking to make it a 2-score advantage here on the road.
And you know they spent all week in practice and meetings talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
And the Vikings, first down. First down, he'll drop to throw.
They brought the house.
Complete. Jefferson the target. He's at the 30.
He's gone.
10. Touchdown, Vikings. Justin Jefferson, his 25th touchdown. Tying Emmitt Smith for the 5th most in one season. And the Vikings get the quick strike touchdown.
Nice.
I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass his young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. Impressed. Aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year. We've seen him settle in now, and you can see the confidence of the team.
Yikes.
Has grown. His confidence has grown. I think that everyone around this guy feels good about what they've seen.
That was just so close to being perfect.
When he's driving home, to turn on Sports Talk Radio. He's okay.
The Bears offense making their way out as we give you a look at the playoff race in the NFC. And with the final fortnight of games upon us, teams jockeying for position. Some of these games really starting to take enormous importance as they always do this time of year.
I like how you use fortnight.
I am impressed.
That means 2 weeks, if I'm not mistaken, correct? But how about exactly what you're talking about? Going down the stretch, how much importance is placed on these games? Like everyone talks about every game's important. When you get to this time of year, maybe that importance gets quadrupled. And that's where we are right now to see who can make their last run, their last push to get into the playoffs.
Nice. Just enough.
Sack, and that is now 21 for him on the year. Wow, what a season. On second down, it's Cohen.
Come on, Kendricks. Thank you, Kendricks.
Across the 45 before he's brought down. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
6 seconds with a snap in time. No.
14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
14. Bears nothing.
They'll run on first down. Montgomery.
Oh, he's gone.
Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there.
Oh, man, he's gone.
Touchdown, Chicago. David Montgomery, his fifth touchdown now on the year.
That was bad defense.
Have cut it to within a score. They were already down two scores early. They needed something to try to stem that tide, and that certainly qualifies a big play to get them in the end zone.
It qualifies indeed, because let's face it, they don't get something done on this drive, turn it back over, this game could be 88 and out the game early.
What? 88 and out the game?
I'm happy it's not. I'm kind of happy they scored, though, because some of these games have been blowouts. Especially against the Bears. Last time we played them, it was a blowout.
It's not 88 now the game. We still got a good game going ahead of us. They'll try and start this drive in the air. The ball popped in the air and intercepted.
Oh, cool.
Jackson picks it, and this one will be brought back.
So what happened was Steven fell over.
He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we gotta give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
This one caught by Ridley. That catch good for only a
wait,
couple.
Calvin Ridley? Surely not.
Play for 2 yards on first down. Coming right, this is Montgomery on the toss.
Yeah.
That'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and nine.
It's now third and nine.
Come on, hold him to a field goal.
The play action fake. They look to throw.
Not even close.
He's gonna go down. Back at the 27-yard line. He's sacked.
That's 3 sacks now, and that's not much of a surprise to me, nor should it be to you. This team, they lead the league in sacks.
Yeah, they do. This is something that we are starting to win.
So close. I wasn't paying attention, though.
Makes the score.
Dang.
They got the interception, but very little movement after. That forces him to settle for three, and it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense, because they ran out to the field. This is what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go play.
All
right,
let's run it, let's run it once. I got to make sure I just throw it away when...
Here's Cook as they begin on the ground.
Oh.
Nice tackle, a yard short of the marker. Good
what?
Gain of nine.
They just...
spot to take a shot here, second and a yard from the 34. They'll look to throw. That's complete to the receiver Thielen, and he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop.
Nice, truck that guy.
Midfield inside the 45. It's a gain of 16, and the Vikings have the first down as well.
Are they bringing the house? I can't tell. No.
Set up to throw. One into the hands of Thielen, complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call,
right,
you got to be really careful as a passer about.
Unfortunately, the Bears are terrible when they play. Oh, wow. When I said the terrible, I meant they put Khalil Mack in coverage instead of.
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game.
Whatever.
The key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Would have been a decently long field goal, 51 yards from here, but instead they're going to go for it. Now back to throw.
Talks about the importance of it, but fourth down, that's truly the moment of truth play, isn't it?
Everything's dialed up a little bit more. It, you know, it's such a momentum play. Touchdown, Chicago! Anthony Miller with touchdown number 7.
How to throw, 1-on-1. Turn the ball over twice.
As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts.
Holy moly. We need to chill.
Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase it.
Won't quite make it to the 25.
It's been like, you guys have seen plenty of videos, but it's been a minute since I've actually played this game a lot. Like, it's been a week since I recorded a video, actually.
Times we sat in meetings with coaches and they used the term complementary football. Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. It's a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover.
I like how every missed pass has been, he's missed two passes and both those passes have been freaking turnovers. It's actually crazy.
Because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well there they ran into a first down. Executed it to perfection.
Okay. Now, 2 minutes, 3 timeouts, we can score it.
Back to throw now on first down. This one brought in by Jefferson.
Oh, such a bad pass.
He'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 17 yards, first down, Vikings.
And the Vikings, first down.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 25 yards there on the catch and run. Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number 3 man to the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in this game.
Yeah, I think he's number 3, but you know who's number 1? Justin Jefferson.
Produce those types of numbers.
7 yards, the pickup there. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3.
Might have a touchdown here. If I can make the throw. Yeah, there you go. Figured out a touchdown.
Justin Jefferson. His 26th touchdown, drawing even with Marshall Faulk for the 4th most in a single season. And the Vikings are going to retake the lead.
Moving up there, 4th most.
And he puts it through. So the drive there took 6 plays. And it all culminates in a touchdown for Minnesota. 17.
All right.
Bailey to kick off for Minnesota.
Bailey now to
kick. We just don't play some deep coverage and try not to give up anything more than a field goal at most in this drive, or nothing at all.
This will make it into the end zone, and no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback
at their own 25-yard line.
The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. But they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here.
Second and 11 at the 24-yard line.
They'll throw now on the final play. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
All right. Let's get one.
Time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the third quarter.
Well, the Jets actually can score points in this league.
It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half.
And all right.
Going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, you're going to
go. All right, Cook. At least you broke the first tackle.
Before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games. And we're seeing a pretty good
game
right now. Highly contested in the third quarter. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
A gain of 6 yards. And it's third down.
Back to throw here. Got an open man finding Jefferson. And down to the 20. A big play for the Vikings on third down. 48 yards. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10.
The dynamic duo is doing damage in this one, and they've certainly been on point throughout. And they hook up again for another big play.
And it's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Brings up second and a yard at the 11-yard line.
This will be caught at about the 6.
Nice. He needs a touchdown every now and then, too.
Touchdown, Vikings. Adam Thielen, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead. And that one pushes the lead up to
11.
The drive summary
of time,
5 plays. And it's polished off.
Actually, I don't know if his next first name is Brian, to be honest, but O'Neal, no.
Bailing out,
I'm center.
Taken about a yard deep.
Nice. Get him.
And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right out.
Oh my god. Really? It's my right tackle. I don't even remember. Shame on me. I should know.
Prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. They trail offense. First time to touch the ball in quarter three. And we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned.
I don't know what I was doing with Kendricks.
Some team script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay.
I keep forgetting that Bars doesn't start in this 5-2, which drives me crazy.
And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after
them. He dropped it.
Create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
Out of the gun now on third down.
Who's the man?
Find Graham complete. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Nice third down conversion at even 20 yards.
And the 42-yard line.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And able to find Lazard.
Lazard, no longer a Packer, huh?
45. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
They're gonna run it, obviously. I mean,
43-yard line.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson.
That running back got smashed, though.
Second and two. A good pick up there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
35-yard line.
On second down.
Ooh.
And yet again, he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Great job by this Vikings defense. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Sometimes in the run game, you can make the argument that quickness beats size.
Nice.
Example right here.
This Minnesota D up to the task on the third down pass play.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, you stand in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open.
No, not enough time. They hit him and force that incompletion. And this one looks good. Down the pipe, and that'll make this an 8-point game. Well, these kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was used for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny when we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find that they were all state quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, all state wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Yeah, I didn't see anything, man. I was like, I didn't want to throw a pick.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And he slings one that's incomplete. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
And it's third down.
Oh, come on, Jefferson. That's two incompletes.
Defensively, they went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines, feel pretty good about themselves, and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted.
God, he's...
Vikings after it, and they get there for the sack. Yannick Ngakoue in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him. On the draw, this is Cohen. Better here as he maybe gets back to the line. Nothing there, no gain, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 15.
It's now 3rd down and 1.
Now they'll throw here.
To Joe Hunter.
In trouble, and he's taken down. Daniil Hunter in there for sack number 22 on the year, and folks, that's just a half sack shy now of Michael Strahan's record of 22 and a half set in 2001. Allen on to punt as he gets this one away. To return is McKenzie.
Dang, that guy is fast.
So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field.
Field general, because his name was Field.
Game so far. He was pretty good in the first half, been good so far here in the third quarter. He's got to like it, right?
Not looking for the dramatics here. Not trying to set the world on fire in terms of stats. It's almost like you're driving. Hands at 10-2, alert for anything out there, watching for trouble on the road, and making sure you get the team home.
The bus driver. See if he can drive the bus here again on this drive. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up 2nd down. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
All right.
1 quarter remains here in week 16. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back to throw again. And that is incomplete. Well, the other day they told us when we've got 3rd and 5 or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point.
Thielen, don't fall down.
They had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so.
Dang, he just got covered perfectly.
Okay. Unable to convert here on 4th.
Which was so good, he was named NFC Defensive Player of the Week. He got a lot of praise, and understandably so.
No!
Media, looking pretty good on that play, too.
And I love what he told us this week before the game. He talked about how much time they spend working on pass rush moves, every position, because anyone can go after the quarterback in their defense, and you can see how they've all observed their lessons.
So a special team's mistake on the field goal try leads to a new set of downs inside the red zone. One down to about the 10-yard line. Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Gosh darn it.
A gain of a yard. Brings up second and nine.
Looking to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10.
Now what?
And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
Oh my god. That was me too. God dang it.
Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all, and now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
Wide open.
Touchdown, Bears. Anthony Miller with his second touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And now the Bears are within a 2-point conversion of tying up the game. So a nice touchdown pass for the rookie there. And you
know, okay, thank God.
And down he goes.
No good.
By the failure to convert and tie the game, now the pressure shifts back to the defense.
But I think it was the right play. I think it was the right call to try and tie the game there. Kick an extra point, you're still down one. What's the sense? I like what they did.
And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. And now out comes Minnesota. A little less than 4 minutes remaining. And the margin for error is small with this slim lead. Operate within your 4-minute offense here, Charles?
Definitely. Remember, the 4-minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario, get enough first downs to make them eat up their timeouts so the game ends when you're kneeling down with the football.
That he's going to get forward for about 5, but that may be coming back. What say you, Mr. Referee?
That's 3 penalties this freaking quarter.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. They run it again with Cook. Tackle made there by Bilal Nichols. I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
Kevin Light, whatever. Here
it is. A big third down has been set up here, partner, and there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here to have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I put the word big in capital letters here. Two minutes remain, and that's our score differential as well. 2 points here in the fourth quarter. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And that will be in.
I hate you.
Knew it too.
Yeah, it's a good call because they wanted to put two men on him, and they did dare him to throw into double coverage. Really, what you're saying is, let's see if one of your other receivers can beat us.
A 40-yard punt, no return, and the Bears take over. So now the Bears down on the scoreboard, and time, a huge factor. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. He'll look to throw, and he gets this one to Ridley complete. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
What?
Obviously a big first down right there.
Hello?
They still got a hustle. They got to get to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it, but they've got to continue to move quickly.
First and 10 at the 48-yard line. To throw, and he finds his tight end Graham. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
And he picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
The Vikings get a signal for the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Oh, my.
Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute. Those are the types of plays in these moments they were hoping for from this young rookie, able to put him up here in the fourth quarter.
How about the kid? You just mentioned it. The fourth quarter. This is when you have to make those winning plays. That's what he just did. Doesn't ensure anything, but he certainly gave his team a heck of a chance, didn't he?
Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And he returns this to the 22.
All right, guys, comeback time, because we managed to throw away a lead.
Situation, but this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep your drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there. And that'll bring up second down. Remaining, they're going to burn their final timeout. now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. One final shot, they'll look to throw. And it's incomplete, so their final drive...
Yikes. Oh my god. I said I never lost a game against the Bears. I mean, dang. Oh, this is a hard game against Seahawks. I just lost my number 2 slot. Next one, thanks for watching, guys, and yeah, until then.